This is Aditya Chakraborty. Today I am going to discuss about the braking of DC motor. So the first slide is the definition of braking. So what is braking? Braking means to stop any DC motor or to stop any type of DC drives or any type of electrical drives. So electric brakes are the device that use an electrical current or magnetic actuating force to slow or stop the motion of a rotating component. That may be a motor or that may be a motor driven device. They are used in industrial and vehicular braking application that require fast response times and precise tension control. So that these are used in case of electric traction, lift, waste, crane. Okay, and that electric braking has a very fast response and a precise or precision control mechanism adapted by the electric brake. Now, the next slide is the classification. So basically, there are three types of electric braking done in a DC motor. Number one, regenerative braking. Number two, dynamic braking. And the last one is the plugging. So at first, regenerative braking. So regenerative braking means there must be a concept of regeneration of electrical energy. So in case of regenerative braking, the motor is act as a generator. So there is a regeneration of electrical energy occurred in case of regenerative braking. So it is a form of braking in which the kinetic energy of the motor is returned to the power supply system. This type of braking is possible when the driven load forces the motor to run at a speed higher than its no load speed with a constant excitation. That means if the excitation remains constant and if the motor is running above its no load speed, then the regenerative braking can be possible. So when the motor running above its no load speed, when it acts as a generator, the motor back EMF EB is greater than the supply voltage. So when the motor is running above its no load speed, then the generated EMF in the motor armature, that is the back EMF, is greater than the supply voltage. That means EB is act as EG. So which reverses the direction of the motor armature current. Okay, the motor begins to operate as an electric generator. It is very interesting to note that the regenerative braking cannot be used to stop a motor. So there is no stop phenomena occurred in case of regenerative braking. So what will happen? In case of regenerative braking, the motor is converted into generator. Or you can say that it is very interesting to note that regenerative braking cannot be used to stop a motor but to control the speed above the no load speed of the motor driving the descending loads. So when a motor is running above its no load speed, at that time the regenerative braking or the regeneration of electrical energy is occurred. Okay, so that is the regenerative braking. Now, the next slide is the regenerative braking image. So by the help of this image, we can understood what is regenerative braking. Here you can see there is a block diagram, one engine or prime mover which is coupled with a DC machine or DC motor and generator. This is a DC machine and this is the power transfer and that is a battery. So when in motor mode, the battery supplied current to the DC motor and DC motor is rotating and hence the mechanical power is transferred through this block and at that time this engine or this prime mover is rotating as a mechanical load. And when this engine rotate first or this prime mover rotate, then the generator also rotate and it induced EMF in the armature and current is supplied to the battery. So at that time the battery is charged. So this is the concept of regenerative braking, and hence the electrical power is transferred from this power transfer block. So this is the regenerative braking image. Now the dynamic braking. This is the simplest form of braking and it is hugely used in case of electric traction. So what is the dynamic braking? It is also known as rheostatic braking. That means there is a variable resistance or rheostat which is connected with the armature of the DC motor. In this type of braking, the DC motor is disconnected from the supply. At first, the DC motor is disconnected from the supply. And a braking resistor RB, R stands for resistance, and B, that is suffix B, stands for the braking, is immediately connected across the armature. So when the motor is disconnected from its supply, at that time, due to inertia, it is rotating in nature, and if we connect a resistance in series with the armature, then this motor is act as a generator and a reduced current is supplied from the armature towards the external load circuit. That means at that time it is act as a generator. So the motor will now work as a generator and produces the braking torque. During electric braking, when the motor works as a generator, the kinetic energy stored in the rotating parts of the motor and a connected load is converted into electrical energy. That means this electrical energy is supplied to the other motors. If there is a group drive or there is a several numbers of motors are connected in parallel, then the first motor is act as a generator and other motors are act as the load. It is dissipated at heat as heat in the braking resistance RB and the armature circuit resistance RA. Although the armature circuit resistance is very low, its maximum value of the armature resistance is 0.5 ohm, but there is a heat produced due to the I square R loss. We know that according to Joule's law, if the time is constant, then I square R proportional to H. So in case of dynamic braking, there is a power loss occurred or there is a heat is produced all time. So dynamic braking is an inefficient method of braking, as all the generated energy is dissipated as heat in the resistance. So that is the dynamic braking. Now the next slide is plugging. It is also known as reverse current braking. The armature terminals or supply polarity of the separately excited DC motor or shunt DC motor when running are reversed. Therefore, the supplied voltage V and the induced EMF or voltage EB, that is back EMF, will act in the same direction. The effective voltage across the armature will be V plus EB, which is almost twice the supply voltage. So if the terminal of the armature is reversed, so what will happen? According to KVL, there is a summation between the induced EMF, that is EB, or back EMF, and the supply voltage V, and which is almost twice to the supply voltage. Thus, the armature current is reversed and a high braking torque is produced. Then the braking torque is very high. And the plugging is a highly inefficient method of braking because in addition to the power supplied by the load, the power supplied by the source is wasted in resistance. So if the braking torque is highly increased, then the heat is also highly generated. Due to if the torque is raised, increased, then current is also increased. So it is also an inefficient method in case of DC motor. But it is very much efficient method in case of three-phase induction motor. Okay. So these are all about the electric braking. Thank you.